Testing the difference between two means with dependent samples. For example, a researcher was interested in the braking distances in feet for the top four brands of tire sets with the car's anti-lock braking system on and the ABS off. The tests were done on wintry conditions with cars traveling at 20 miles per hour. The researcher believes the mean braking distance would be shorter with the ABS on. The results of the braking distance in feet are listed below. At the 1% level of significance, is there sufficient evidence to support this claim? For this example, we are going to test a claim using the dependent samples technique. Note that this is an example of dependent samples because we are analyzing four sets of tires, with each set being tested with the ABS on and off. So for step one, we are going to state our hypotheses. For the null hypothesis, the statement will always be mu d is equal to zero. Where mu d is the population mean of the paired differences. Again, we are assuming that there is no difference between the means of the two groups. The researcher believes the mean braking distance would be shorter with the ABS on, so using notation, the alternative hypothesis would be mu d is less than zero. Please note that less than is used because the test is performed to determine if the mean braking distance would be shorter with the ABS on. Also, since we are using less than, the braking distances with ABS on must be group 1, and the braking distances with ABS off must be group 2. For the second step, we're going to state the level of significance. And for this example, the level of significance, which is alpha, is equal to 0.01. For the third step, we're going to compute the test statistic. Using the values from the scenario, the values of the differences must be found before we can make note of the sample mean and standard deviation of the paired differences. Recall, the braking distances with ABS on must be group 1, and the braking distances with ABS off must be group 2. Be careful not to confuse the two groups. Subtracting incorrectly will result in erroneous results. So I'm just going to rewrite the data so I can list the actual distances with ABS on and with ABS off. Next, I'm going to create a differences column. And we must do this before we're able to actually determine the mean and standard deviation. So we're going to subtract by taking group 1 minus group 2. And this is why it's important to label the correct groups so that you subtract the correct way. So we're going to take our first group minus the second group and determine our differences. From the list of differences, now we can determine the mean and standard deviation. And the formula for the mean is d bar is equal to the sum of the differences divided by the sample size. And so that results in negative 14.5. For the standard deviation of the differences, we have the sum of the deviation squared over n minus 1. And again, don't forget to take the square root of that. So once you do the math, you get 1.9149. So using this information, we can now plug it into our formula. And recall that since there is no difference between the two groups, mu sub d will always equal 0. So for our actual test statistic, we have the following formula. So we're able to plug in our values. So we'll have negative 14.5 minus 0. And again, the mean difference is 0, so that's why we use 0, divided by the standard deviation over the square root of n. And once you do the math on that, you get negative 15.14. The fourth step is now to determine the critical value. Using this approach, we make note of alpha and the symbol used for the alternative hypothesis. So since this is a left-tailed test, we're going to draw this out, shade to the left, and identify the rejection region. Recall that that area is equal to alpha, which is 0.01. So for this test, since we're using a t, we have to identify the degrees of freedom, and that's equal to n minus 1. So there were 4 subjects, 4 minus 1 is 3. So using the t table in a left-tailed test with 3 degrees of freedom and 0.01 in the tail, our critical value is negative 4.541. Our test statistic of negative 15.14 clearly falls in the rejection region, and we're able to state our decision and our conclusion in step 5. So our decision is to reject the null hypothesis. And for our conclusion, we can state that there is sufficient evidence to suggest that the mean breaking distance with ABS on is shorter than the mean breaking distance with ABS off.